Hello, I am Sharon Beekman, Chair of the EPC Women's Resource Council. The Council administers the EPC Women's Ministry called the Well Women's Resources. We exist to serve you, women in EPC churches, and we want to help you connect with the EPC women across our denomination and to provide resources for ministry in the local church. Please visit our website, blog, and Facebook group. The link to the blog and Facebook can be found on the EPC website. On the website, you'll also find vetted resources on discipleship, evangelism, healing, prayer, and leadership. We selected ones to help you grow in your love for Christ, to be bold in your faith, and to be equipped to serve Him. The resources are biblically based and theologically sound. In this video series, council members want to bless you as they share personal experiences and insights in their journey with Christ. Rebecca Duvall, our council member from the Presbytery of Pacific Southwest, will now talk about the belt of truth from Ephesians 6:14.
I'd like to talk to you today about the armor of God, found in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 14 to 18. I don't know about you, but I struggle with accessories, earrings, belts, scarves, shoes, what to put on and when. But God has a set of accessories for us that He desires us to wear every day, the armor of God. And this isn't something just to put on as a checklist, another thing to do to start our day. There's a purpose behind it. The armor of God is a protection from God, as well as a way for Him to draw us closer to Him. The belt of truth is the power of God, knowing that we have it available to us and that we can use it throughout our day, regardless of our circumstances, and to help us stay grounded in Him. The breastplate of righteousness is not our righteousness, but the righteousness of Christ, and being grounded in what Christ Jesus did for us on the cross, that He paid the ultimate price for us, and helping us remember that God loves us so deeply that He gave His one and only Son to us. God desires us to be fitted with the gospel of peace. Now, how are we fitted with the gospel? Being fitted is being able to stand firm with God so that we may receive His peace, regardless of the season that we're in, regardless of the circumstances. I recently went through a time that I was struggling with God's peace. So I had to, through a friend, thankfully, learned that I needed to take some time and ask God to help me to refit my shoes because they had worn out. But that's an amazing thing about the armor of God, that there may be a piece that we struggle with or maybe that we have lost, but that we can always go to God and ask Him to help us to be refitted with maybe the gospel of peace so that we are firmly standing with Him, or maybe to help ground us and remember the power and the strength that we have through Him. There's also some pieces of the armor of God that He would like us to take up. There's an action that we need to take. We have a part that He desires us to play. One of these things is the shield of faith. And this is a piece that shows that we firmly believe in God and all that He stands for. That we believe and we trust what His Son Jesus has done for us. That He has paid the ultimate price. That He has paid for our sins, and that we have access to God and all that He has. There's also the helmet of salvation, and this is knowing that God deeply loves you and He calls you to Him. And there's many ways that He calls us to Him, through our time of prayer, through His Word, the Bible, that as we read it and we study it, He reveals Himself to us. He speaks to us, and He guides us. He also does that through the people that He puts around us. He brings us encouragement. He will also use the people and the circumstances around us to maybe help us to see a calling that He has put on our life, to confirm something that He is calling us to. And there's also the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. He desires us to daily, regularly read His Word and study it and to discuss it with other fellow Christians so that we can encourage one another on each of our walks and to know when He is talking to us and what He is saying, and just for encouragement. Because sometimes there could be something going on in our lives that we feel lost. We don't understand. Even times of joy where I find myself sometimes the better things are going, the easier things are, the more I can get distracted and lost from God, because I sometimes think, oh, I'm good, I don't need Him. Because I'm good, I've got it, I've worked through it, but then there's the next thing that comes along. So staying grounded in the Word of God, in the Bible, daily, regularly, regardless of my circumstances, whether I'm high up on the mountain or feeling down low, deep in the pit, that God's Word continually reveals Himself to me, His love, His encouragement, and reminds me that I am surrounded by His people and that He has resources around me at all times that help draw me to Him. And He'd also like us to continue to pray for one another. He wants us to be alert and to pray, and not just for our fellow Christians, but for everyone at all times, because everyone, regardless of whether they know God, they're a child of God. So we are to pray for them. Be alert of your surroundings, the people that God places in your life, because He wants us to stand firm and pray continually so that we can be protected and that we can be drawn closer to Him. So don't forget to put on your armor of God so that God can bless you through it and you can be a blessing to others that God has surrounded you with.
I hope this discussion has been a blessing to you. For more information on The Well, please see our website and blog and connect with us on social media. Thank you for watching, and may God richly bless you today.